Hey guys. Hope that you're all doing well today. As most of you know, my wife and I, we run a coffee shop together, and a good friend of mine, the one who roasts our beans for us, is Roast Our Beans. Is our bean roaster. The guy who makes our coffee. So his wife wanted to surprise him for his birthday last week, and contacted us, as we also do leather work, and asked us if we can make a leather Bible cover for him as a surprise. I said yes, never made one before. So decided to make a video myself and make it and kind of record the process along and show you guys how to do the same or something similar. Our friend is very simple. He likes things really simple, and that's the design we went for as well. Something really simple but really cool looking and smooth to the touch, you know. So I just measured out the Bible, drew a simple design of what I wanted, messaged the wife, sent a picture to her to check if it was okay. She loved it, so I just drew up a template on the computer, very simple, in like Microsoft Word or something simple like that. I made sure that the sizes were correct, printed it out, and cut it out ready to use. Once your templates are finished, the next step is to choose your leather. I went with a 1.2 to 1.4 mil veg tan, which I just personally really enjoy. Once you've chosen your leather, you can go and just cut those out using the template, mark them, cut them out, and there we go. You should have your four pieces, your main panel, the two side panels, and then the little piece for your clip as well. I then rounded off the edges on the main panel, the big piece, just to give it a nice round finish and just to make it more smooth, and instead of having those corners which are a lot more easily damaged. Before you move on, make sure to test it. Put it around the book, the journal, the Bible. Make sure that you haven't cut it too short, that there is going to be enough space to put the other panels on, and that there's still room for stitching as well. I then rounded one edge of the small piece of leather that's going to be used for the clip to close the Bible. I then burnished the piece and made the hole for the clip to go. I then stitched the flat piece, or the straight side of it, to the main piece of the Bible cover, and just did two lines of stitches just to make sure it's nice and firm and, you know, doesn't come off if it's to be tugged on or pulled on, just for that extra safety and support. And then put the side panels down so that I know exactly where the glue needs to go, because many times before I've just glued straight around without even realizing and had to start completely again. I glued the panels to the main part of the Bible cover and then cut away any excess, though the corners that weren't round, which I prefer to do afterwards just in case it doesn't line up or anything. The next thing I did is just marked and grooved in my stitching lines all around the Bible cover, just giving it a nice even and good looking straight stitch. Using my stitching fork, I then just made all the holes for the stitches to go in all around the main piece. You really just want to be patient with this step. You don't want to rush making your holes, just so that everything lines up nicely at the end and that your finished product looks really good. Once you're done making all the holes, it's now time for the longest part of the project, the stitching. Remember, always cut enough thread. The worst thing you can do is be 3/4 through or halfway through stitching and realize you're not gonna have enough and have to completely restart if you're wanting a nice consistent stitch. So make sure you cut enough. And as you can see, I used quite a lot. Once I was done with all the stitching, I then burnished up the sides just using some water. You can use whatever you usually use, or you don't need to burnish it at all. I just wanted to make it a little bit softer to the touch, so I just used a little bit of water for that. Next, I just added the cross to the front cover and on the side, just to give it a very simple look. You're welcome to put a name there or just to leave it plain too. Once I was done burnishing and adding the cross, I then just sealed the leather using a leather seal from Woodheads. Now, you don't have to seal the leather. You're welcome to just leave it plain. I just really like the way it finishes off the leather and also just helps protect it. And then the big moment comes where you got to put it all together and make sure that everything fits well and that all the sizes match up, which it did, luckily. There's definitely been times in the past where I haven't measured enough and get to the end, and after all your stitching and all your hard work, you realize that something went wrong. So, as the cliche goes, measure twice, cut once, but that can really be a lifesaver a lot of the time. I'm really happy with the way the cover turned out. Such a simple design, very easy to do, obviously just takes some time, but so nice to just hold in your hands, flip through the pages, be able to have that leather smell, and yeah, just have something unique and something that you made, or something that you made for a friend. It's just really cool. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing and hitting that little bell, which just notifies you of all our new videos as they are posted so that you can be one of the first to watch it. Thank you so much for joining. That is it for today. It was so good having you, and we will see you in the next video. Let me know in the comments below how yours turned out. And we will see you in the next video. You can still kind of see me in there if you... It's always this, like, smudge right here. Probably shouldn't be using this, but...